What struck me about this speech was he drew a line in the sand, and essentially it's not a unity speech. Mm-hmm. It's really a speech that says, you know, those people, and we know who he's referring to, right? The person is absent, chose not to come because perhaps she knew she would be referred to. He's saying that, hey, I'm going to run after you, hammer and tongs. And I think if he does not do that, that perhaps will, I think that will be the standard that we will judge his administration. Not necessarily that he will be able to get convictions, but if he does not run after them really with determination, then people are going to say perhaps that he didn't fulfill his promise.
But you know, that's an easy promise to make. I'll go after my personal enemies, the people I don't like to meet. Mm. What was really remarkable here is that he said he will go after armed officials where we sink billions of pesos and that's we right. never see it yeah. again. Mm. And when Boeing and I tried to investigate that, we basically were told, you want to die? Mm-hmm. So forget it. He has exposed what congressmen do with their pork. Mm. He has declared war on local governments practices. Basically, he has said things that only a president who is not interested in re-election right. of his friends in the next congressional elections will say. Mm. Remember, he cannot run for president. But every president really, we always go to them and say, pardon naman, please naman, you don't, we all know that the era is bad, but always we say, don't touch it. But because when we run for re-election, the local government guys will go after us. He has drawn the line on the sand against everybody in that house. Right. Mm-hmm. And said, what you did before, it's not going to happen again. Mm.
But he has stopped short of calling people who actually are the source of this corrupt money, businessmen, people who have to make transactions with governments. Mm-hmm. Why doesn't he say, wag na tayong maglagay? Even to the ordinary driver, the jeepney driver who is accosted because of some traffic violation, and all he does is just pay off, so he doesn't get his license collected. Is this something that can be said in a speech like this? Now, the source of the money comes from us, the private citizens.
No. I think one is businessmen do not corrupt politicians. They usually tell politicians to go to hell. In fact, the practice now is when you want to ask for campaign contributions, they say, manalo ka muna, then I'll give you money. That's really what's happened to elections. What happens really is the corruption is the public treasury is plundered.
Right.
It's plundered in overpriced
projects.
It is not
the corruption, the graft that is also shown by businessmen who want to keep their business and who don't want to be examined by the Bureau of Internal Revenue.
That's different.
That's
only specific to BIR, and apparently he has said the BIR is going to go after tax cheats.
Yes. Mm.
So he's even said that. You were even afraid to say that before. Allowing the bank secrecy law to be lifted, no president would say it because the banker said, oi, most of the money in here is stolen, huh? So you want to shake up the economy?
Okay, so the transformation comes from the transformation or the word that the Wang Wang has come to be known today. Is that what this whole thing is all about?
I was going to criticize him for saying transformation because I don't like presidents telling me to change when he hasn't changed yet. But you know what? He said the right thing. Mm. He said, I don't know if you're going to change or not, but I am changing the way government is going to be done. Mm. And there will be no opportunities for corruption. So you may as well change and be honest because you're just going to get no chance to be dishonest. And it's very good. As a speech, may not be much, but as a message, wow. I'm impressed.
Professor, actually, what he's doing is he's changing the rules of the game. And for so long, the old ways of playing the game has been accepted and institutionalized at that.
Sabi niyo nga, transactional.
Transactional. Right? An abusive form of transactional politics. But now he is, well, this is characteristic of his so-called stubbornness as a person, but he's putting it to positive use. He's saying no more. And in fact, what strikes me from the speech is that, you know, this country, we are a nation of unfinished businesses. And, you know, our strength as a people is we are generous with our forgiveness, but our weakness is that we forget too easily. So I think he is setting an example by saying those who say that we should move on and just forget about it are not doing this country any service. We should put a closure, but there should be justice. There should be reckoning.
And that process of closure, yes, that you speak about, is that all in the legal front?
Not necessarily.
Are these all going to happen if cases are filed against the people who are found to be corrupt?
Well,
is the battleground now in the ombudsman, in the various courts?
I think it was
the Supreme
very,
Court. Yeah.
I think it's very significant that he announced the appointment of the new ombudsman here at his State of the Nation address. And I think that was a signal that you can read it one way or another, but the way I would read it is, okay, we have an ombudsman now. Let her be the one to run after these people, and I'm going to focus on running this government,
right,
under the terms that Teddyboy and, of course, we've been discussing here. No? Is it just going to be in the legal front? The problem is perhaps some of the corruption and other things that were done, maybe it was done so well you can't run after them. There are certain things that will never be found. But I think, to make it specific, now, for example, the theft of the elections in 2004, can you still really legally make people accountable for that? Maybe not. But there are other forums to do that. But for me, specifically, dapat talaga ma-file na ng kaso yung mga tao na nagnakaw.
Hindi nga. Pero the moment you file a case, then it's all there in the courts, and the public loses interest to follow the progress of how these cases are, because all they need to do is, yes, we filed a plunder case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we filed this case of plunder and all sorts of things, and they come up with decisions, and people just forget about it. How do you keep that momentum?
I think there will be a difference. That is an excellent choice, former Justice Morales. She will decide many of the accusations that have been thrown, like the NBN ZTE deal. There's no way you can jail anybody for that. She stopped it. Mm-hmm. So there was no loss of money. Mm-hmm. But you're going to see Conchita Morales throw out some cases because she says this cannot be prosecuted. And when she focuses on the things that can be prosecuted, you know you're going to get results because she's a really smart lady.
All right, let's go over now live to the Batasan. Our colleague TJ Manotok is there, I guess, for some reactions to the President SONA. TJ?
Hi, Tony, Tina. Yes, in the mad rush of trying to get VIPs and political figures running out or heading out of the session hall, we got with us right now former Senator and former U.S. Ambassador Maseda. Sir, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Thank you for joining us. Sir, your thoughts on President Aquino's second State of the Nation address?
Well, on first blush, everything sounded good. Mm-hmm. But there were so many things that were not really talked about.
Okay.
Specifically, for example, I was hoping he would have a program of how he would bring down prices.
Okay.
Secondly, you know, it's nice to hear that he gave out 4,000 units to the police.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to take that in the context that the 2011 Philippine Development Plan calls for 70,000.
Mm-hmm.
So 4,000 out of 70,000 is a drop in the bucket.
Mm-hmm.
If you take the bigger macro picture of 3.6 million shortage of housing units, constructing 4,000 in 1 year is too small, too slow. But I mean, say everything he said is good, but still not enough, too slow. And definitely on the corruption front, there has been some progress because of PCSO, PANCOR, and AFP, but still more has got to be done.
With regards to the choice of the ombudsman, what is your reaction to that?
It's an excellent choice, and I only hope that Mr. Mosquera or Mr. Toguero or Mr. Armamento would agree to be deputy.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Anything else that you would have liked to hear about? Interestingly, there was no mention of education.
Yes,
well, some people
yes,
hoping it is a high priority.
I was hoping that he would say that for 2012, just as I'm giving $53 billion to conditional cash transfer on the SWD, I'll give $53 billion to get rid of the classroom shortage once and for all.
All right, sir, I'll turn over now to our anchors in the studio. We have Tony Velasquez and Tina Palma.
Yes.
They'll be asking questions to you. Tony,
yes.
Tina?
Yes, hello, Tony. Hello, Tina. Hello, Adel. And hello, Teddyboy.
Wow.
Right. Ganda po, Senator. Matanong ko lang po, yung isa sa portions nung SONA ni Pangulong Aquino at ito po bilang isang dating ambassador natin, ano po yung reaction nyo dun sa medyo matapang po na statement ni Presidente na ang sa Pilipinas ay sa Pilipinas, wala tayong balak mang away pero dapat handa tayong ipagtanggol yung sa atin. Of course, an obvious reference to the Recto Bank na sabi nga niya pag umapak ka doon, para ka nang umapak sa Recto Avenue. Ibig sabihin ba nun, ganun na rin kadumi?
Actually, lahat ng applause was para bang respectful applause. That was the only genuine applause where everybody applauded. Mm. So it was a good nationalistic statement, and that was the highlight of his speech.
Mm. But you know, as a diplomat, having been a diplomat yourself, how easy is it to back up those words when you're already confronted with what China is doing in the Spratlys? I mean, currently we're looking at a situation where the Chinese aggressively pursuing their territorial claims, and we're just complaining about what they're doing, but not being able to actually repel or resist any of those moves.
Well, let's be realistic. It has got to be done more through diplomacy. One Hamilton-class destroyer is nothing against 400 or 500 Chinese ships and submarines.
Yeah. All right. Well, definitely. All right. Ambassador Moseda, Senator Moseda, one of the other things, of course, that I guess people really appreciated in the president's speech is that he made all these repeated references to yung mga utak wang-wang, you know, and people, of course, reacting positively because they think that now the president is really hitting at the source of what's wrong in this country. People think that they can get away with anything kung malakas sila, pwede sila magpalusot, pwede magpadulas. Do you think that the president really has made some headway with trying to remove that culture of utak wang-wang in this country?
Well, 1 year is over, Antonio, and let's just hope that he will be able to improve his performance. And definitely, there is a need to rebuff the cabinet. Definitely, there's got to be more imagination and creative programs. And but let's hope for the best. And it's right for him to try to solicit the assistance of the citizenry. But then he must set the example, and I think he can set the example by quitting smoking to begin with.
All right, on that
note,
Ambassador, former Senator Moseda, thank you
All
very
right.
much.
Thank and, you, Senator.
Thank you. And thank you very much as well to our colleague TJ Manato, who's there at the Batasan. All right, let's hear some reactions now from our social networking sites. And Mai Rodriguez joins us from the news desk to give us all of that. Mai?
Thanks, Tony. Well, it's no surprise that SONA 2011 is among the top topics trending online right now. Immediate reactions on Twitter were from Congressman Sunny Angara, who noted that it's his first time to hear a presidential joke in the SONA in his 7 years as congressman. Lawyer Teddy Te also said this was a catchy, familiar, and also easy to remember SONA. He also says it's a much better written speech than SONA 2010. Former President Estrada spokesperson Margot Salcedo, meanwhile, said something about the president's employment figures. Well, Bayan Muna Congressman Neri Colmenares asked, is anyone monitoring how many times Pinoy mentioned the word wang-wang? Well, to answer Congressman Colmenares, according to our tally, the president mentioned wang-wang about 20 times, and he was applauded about 48 times. The loudest, I think, was when he announced the appointment of retired Justice Conchita Carpio Morales as the next ombudsman, and when the president mentioned upgrading the capability of our armed forces, and also his bold statement about pursuing the country's territorial claims. And to our online followers, we also look forward to your comments about what you think of the president's SONA. Send us your comments on Facebook. Since we've reached our daily limit on our Twitter account, we'll also upload more videos on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/ANC Alerts. That's what's brewing at the news desk. Back to you, Tony and Tina.
Thank you, Mai.
Thank you very much, Mai. Let's go to that portion about his explanation or his style of leadership. Did he distinguish or define himself differently from what you and I see him to be as far as leadership or managing the country as president?
I think this is a, this is finally a clearer definition. He is not going to be an inspirational leader by any means, but he's just going to push along, plod along in that straight path that, that he wants the country to take. As I said, you may not exactly know where that straight path is. It may not exactly be the best path to take because there may be a hole in front of you. But definitely, he's not going to ever take us back to the way things were. And he's and the thing that's really remarkable is, actually, he hasn't a concept focused on GMA. He has focused on the kind of corruption he knew was going on in Congress. And that was never said in any SONA. And now he's willing to go after that. That means he's willing to lose political support in Congress, which anyway, you don't really need once you're president because you can always have a reenacted budget.
All right. All right, let's go over quickly to the Batasan again, to TJ Manotok. I understand that he's now talking to Cavite Representative Elpidio Barzaga. TJ?
All right, thanks, Tony. Beside me right now, we have Congressman Bragaza from Dasmanias. Sir, your reactions to this President's State of the Nation address?
Well, of course, I really appreciate the SONA of the President because it is very clear, it is very definite, and he is really straight to the point. In so far as the course of action which he has to take in the next 5 years.
Well, were you surprised of his promise that he will be delivering the budget to the legislature as soon as tomorrow?
We are not surprised because we know that the president's men are always ready insofar as their obligations are concerned. Let me state that the president started regarding his policy of Wangwang. It has been a policy which is stated during the last SONA, and it has been enforced for a period of 1 year. He wants to imply or suggest that as long as we have a policy like Wangwang, it can be followed by our people. And I wish also to emphasize that the president stated the economic factors which would be necessary for development. Number one, there is an increase in credit standing of the Philippines. Number two, there is an increase in the volume of transactions in the stock market. Number three, there has been a reduction in so far as the interest payments are concerned. And all these factors are indicative that there is really that the factors necessary for economic growth are actually existing, and therefore we can expect that in the coming months or years we will really see tangible achievements insofar as development is concerned.
All right, Congressman Barzaga, we have with us in the studio Tony Velasquez, Tina Palma. They'll be asking questions to you as well. Tony, Tina?
We have a lot of tweets here. Thank you very much, Tony, and Congressman, for joining us in this portion. We'll get back to you there in Batasan Pambansal. Let me get back to our analysts here, or commentators, if you may. The style of leadership. Did you think everybody else was thinking of a different style of leadership when he assumed his role as president? Or is he now defining for himself, this is what I will be and you better take me for how I do my business as president? Is that... Or you think he will try to adjust to how people think he should be running this country?
No, more or less, I think he has defined himself.
He's defined himself. You see that in the way cabinet meetings or cabinet cluster meetings are held, and he doesn't call for big cabinet meetings, and they have a reason for that. So how do you see his style? What is the President Aquino's style of leadership?
Well, as I've said earlier, it's a more passive but positive approach to power. I think it's also a
passive
in the sense that he is not one to exercise the institutional trappings of the presidency.
But does he come up with ideas on what on how to go about improving, let's say, the different programs that are being presented to him by cabinet secretary?
Of course, from what I know, and I also had the opportunity of seeing him in person when he was congressman, I think he is a very, very brilliant individual. He's well-read. He's actually a policy wonk. In fact, it's
policy what?
Wonk. Wonk, somebody who's into policy, who would who would look at a particular bill or a budget and would really look at all the nitty-gritty of that.
And that's a real shame, because his three communicators don't seem to bring that out.
Exactly.
My God, you know, it means something that someone is interested. I remember Marcos, and talk about a real intellectual, Marcos was, but his men allowed him to project that. It was heavy, Marcos's message. If he is like that, why are they stopping him? Why are they trivializing him?
Yeah, that, and this speech definitely does not bring that across. It is not a speech that capitalizes on his perhaps intellectual gifts. No, I mean, because for me, if I were to analyze how he delivered it, the he was, it's more to the masa. I think that was the stakeholder that he was addressing it to. It wasn't to Congress.
Yes.
He wasn't saying this will be the legislative policy that I want you to do because of the state of the nation. That's why, personally, you know, to do a little bit of a critique in terms of style, I really prefer, and you know, if I can pat Teddyboy a little bit on the back, no, I prefer the speeches, let's say, Cory's speeches, even some glorious, because there's a bit of a higher tone. It's more, yeah, it's more, there were jokes in the, like the first time that there was really like a joke in the speech itself.
It was a good joke.
Oh, it was a good joke.
Well, I think one factor to consider here is it's part of the generation ship also, and he's addressing a different public. We have a younger public. We are no longer, this is the generation that we call the millennials. And this is no longer the generation XYZ of the 90s, but rather this is a new Facebook, Twitter type of generation.
And
I think
generation.
I think his message is targeted towards this constituency more than anyone else.
Well, if that's the case, then he should really be allowed to bring out what you say are his gifts, because tweeting and Facebook really require you to show that you have something between your ears.
Right. True.
And this is not what his communicators are doing.
All right, let's communicate some more with our colleague TJ Manotok. He's still there at the Batasan Pambansa. He's also joined by Congressman Roy Logoles. TJ?
All right, Tony, right now I'm with Representative Roy Legoles from Parañaque. Sir, good afternoon. Thank you for joining us.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Your reactions to the President's SONA today?
Well, my first reaction is that he was able to use in a very eloquent way the symbolism of Wangwang. Wangwang, the Wangwang policy, not only to address those who are lording it over in the streets of Manila, but lording it over in governance, in taxation, even in the spratlys, graft and corruption, rice importation, and so many other problems that are besetting the country, and he would like to address in a more telling way in the coming year. Well, he did that already, but he's going to refocus on this in the coming years of his term.
Last year, he promised top priority would be jobs creation.
Yes.
He did mention the drop in the unemployment rate, but he did also clarify it's a moving target. It's every year, there's a lot of fresh graduates. I understand in Parañaque, in your district, in your city, there's a lot of development of call centers coming up.
That's
and
right, call centers, and then the entertainment city that can generate about 200,000 jobs. 1.4 million, according to him, and according to the speaker earlier, 1.4 million new jobs created, and at the same time also creating opportunities for business through this Pantawid sa Pamilya. So marami makikinabang dito. At pagkatapos, binanggit din niya, yung, you know, that figure was really very shocking. That yung binanggit niya yung mga nagbabayad ng taxes ng mga those in the private sector na andito yung figure na nakakagulat yung binanggit niyang figure kasi lumalabas na about 1.7 million taxpayers mm-hmm. paying only a little over 9.8 billion pesos, or roughly about that. Mm-hmm. And that translates to even lower than the minimum wage. These are supposed to be professionals, self-employed, matataas ang antas sa buhay, mm-hmm. pero ang baba-baba pala. So mm-hmm. that is going to be addressed also. Mm-hmm. Yan yung mga nagbawang-wang pagdating sa pagbayad ng mga taxes.
Lastly, sir, anything that you felt that was missing from the SONA today, as much as the many good news that he gave out, ano pong nawala sa tingin
mo? Well, we cannot be comprehensive. We cannot be all encompassing about this. But there is one very clear message also. Mm-hmm. And to me, this is very unifying. Mm-hmm. You know, all of us have been disturbed by the supposed conflict between the state and the church. Mm-hmm. Yung pagbabangayan. Pero mabuti na banggit niya si Cardinal Vidal, mm-hmm. si Cardinal Rosales, si Cardinal Palma, at sinabi niya na dapat mawala na yung bangayan mm-hmm. ng Estado at ng simbahan. Mm-hmm. You know, what we need now is to unify the country and not to divide the country. And to me, that message is a very strong message.
All right, thank you, sir, for your time.
Thank you very much.
All right, Tony, joining us still here, while I still have the time, is we have DISB Secretary Jesse Robredo. Sir, can you step in here? Yeah. You're already wired up. And sir, I guess, your initial reactions to the President's State of the Nation address today?
First of all, I'm impressed, even if I've seen the draft SONA last Thursday.